Welcome to the How Soccer Explains Leadership podcast, where we explore leadership principles through the lens of the beautiful game.
Welcome back to How Soccer Explains Leadership, and we are actually back. We are back for season 7. Paul and I are here today to just really just have a conversation about what's to come, about what we've done over the summer, just about our summer series, and just kind of bring us all back into the normal, right? Hopefully everything is going to go back to normal, like totally normal soon. But, you know, we can only wish for certain things, but we know How Soccer Explains Leadership. Hopefully we're leading the charge into that. So, Paul, how was your summer, man?
It was great, man. And back to what's normal. I don't know what normal is.
It's, I don't either, but I just thought I'd say that. It sounded right.
Whatever we're into right now, this is our normal, but I like the idea of getting back into the How Soccer Explains Leadership routine, but the normalcy of that every week is exciting, and enjoyed what was put together through the summer as well. But yeah, summer was great for the Jobson household and the Warrior Way and Warrior Way Gives things that went on this summer. So yeah, things were solid, man.
Yeah, so what were some of those things? What did you guys do?
Probably the coolest thing we did is our Gives program. We took a group of about 32 people down to Guatemala, and that's our international partner down there, and served that area down there with a bunch of different things we did. It was just a really amazing time. We did an all abilities clinic with a group that basically is the Guatemalan national team for their disabilities group. And that is really an amputee group. It's amputee national team. So really cool project down there. Worked with some communities, some villages, some children, did some clinics, did some coaching clinic. And just really, you know, anytime you do a service project, you go to serve and you come back probably more filled than, you know, maybe you feel like you left down there. But great, great partnerships that we're building in Guatemala, and looking forward to going back next summer. And honestly, looking if there are teams that want to get a group together to go play some games and serve down in Guatemala, we're going to put some things like that together too. But our group will go down annually and serve our communities that we're building relationships down there, really around the Antigua area is primarily where we're serving. But our goal is to go deep, not wide. So we're going to continue to pour into those communities and villages that we're building relationships with. So that was awesome. And then our Warrior Way side, you know, we did our summer camps in Waco and building some relationships up in Wheaton, Illinois as well, and did a camp up there, which was really, really great, and looking to probably grow that next summer as well. But again, try not to go too wide, just trying to go really deep in the areas that we're serving on the Warrior Way and the Warrior Way Gift side. But it was a very productive summer from those two ideas, and ton of family time, obviously, which is, you know, the reason I stepped away from college coaching. So definitely have stepped wholly into that this summer as well. So it was some great stuff. What about you, man? What were some things that you were able to get done this summer too?
Yeah, that's great. That's all so great to hear those different things. I mean, obviously my heart on the international front, to be able to connect with those people and really go deep with them and do life with them. Yeah. And have that incarnational ministry, that incarnational, just really be able to do life with people is there's nothing like it, especially on that cross-cultural, to be able to do it ourselves and also introduce other kids and adults as well who have never done it. It not only opens our eyes to, you know, everyone says opens our eyes to what we have. Yeah, but it also opens our eyes to joy that people have in not having a lot. And for us to be able to see that, and joy isn't about what we have. It's really about relationships. It's really about the family we have. It's about our community. It's about, you know, being able to do life with people in real deep ways and to know and be known. And so that's what some of the stuff I just love about being able to connect in these different communities and then being able to do your camps and stuff. We still talked about it. We got to make it happen out here in California. Hopefully next summer we can do it. I mean, not right now. It's 180,000 degrees, it seems like. Actually, 117 the other day here in Folsom. Wow. And we got fires and we got bad air and we got all kinds of stuff. So you don't want to come right now. But, you know, there's other times where it's awesome.
Yes.
And you can come at those times, and we'll make it happen. We'll make it happen one of these days. So hearing about some new fields being built and that we can,
awesome.
we can do some cool stuff. So anyway, this summer, man, I talked a little bit throughout as we had this summer series that we did, but the highlight for me was the family time we had, be able to go on a road trip, be able to, you know, we did the road trip reels, I think we call them. I can't remember exactly what we call them, but I was able to do some highlights from the trip with, you know, some lessons built in. It's just what I do, man. I can't help it. I can't help, you know, doing life lessons and different leadership lessons from these cool things. I think I honestly, I was pretty proud of the one of the salt flats that I thought about when we were there. And it was, you know, that whole African proverb of, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. And that, you know, made me think about that there. So, you know, that was just a really cool thing. If you didn't check that out, go check it out on Instagram. We've got some of those lessons that I thought about throughout. That's some pretty cool places around the country we were able to go to. A lot of the national parks. Black Hills was an amazing place that, you know, I thought was going to just be Mount Rushmore and then a couple other little things. But it's an amazing, beautiful, just beautiful place. Kind of go from nothing, and then, wow, amazing Black Hills Forest with Rushmore and Badlands close by and Devil's Tower and Deadwood and all these cool things. The Needles Highway, if you ever go in that area, do not miss the Needles Highway. It is amazing, amazing stuff. So that was really cool. Yellowstone, incredible. Being able to go to Tetons, you know, we went through Boise, saw some friends. Colorado did, you know, it, what was interesting is like going through Yellowstone and Tetons and Black Hills, and then we get to Colorado, which is amazing. And it was kind of like, oh yeah, Pikes Peak. All right, yeah, Guard of the Gods. All right, whatever. You know, and it was the end of our trip too. So the kids are like, all right, yeah, that's cool. But it's not like this other stuff we just did is dry and it's not, you know, true. So it was funny. I guess we set the bar really high for the kids now. They're like, eh, whatever. But yeah, so that was really cool. Also was able to do some disc training with some great teams. So, you know, in Colorado, great teams out here in California, did a couple in Iowa. And I just take such great joy from that. Also have learned a lot of things that I know will come out over this, the course of our podcast, just about who are the kids we're losing, you know, what are the different personality styles that we're not coaching to at all. And we're not speaking their language at all, and we're losing them. And I think we'll probably do a whole episode on that at some point, because I'm going to be doing some informal study over the next few months with some different clubs. If you are a club out there, if you're a coach or a DOC or something out there, and you want to be part of this, I'm going to basically be giving disc assessments to these clubs for cost. And just so I can learn about kids at the younger ages, what are their styles? That, and then as they grow through the elite and go into ECNL, who are we losing? Is it certain personality styles? Because it appears, based on the college makeup, the teams, we're losing kids who are wired, who are motivated and driven by fun, and we're losing the kids who are really driven by that excellence and quality. They're too hard on themselves usually. So it's interesting. We as coaches have a big part to play in that. And so it's something that I've really been paying a lot of attention to. The teams look a lot like their coaches too, and most coaches are very task focused. And so anyway, that's something that I was able to do, and I just take such great joy. If you can't tell from the conversations we've had, doing that disc training, being able to see light bulbs go on in people's minds and lives, being able to follow, you know, be a part of these teams, talking with these coaches to be able to really help them through difficult times when their teams are going through rough patches, when their teams are going through the highs and the lows, and how can we connect these players and teach them life lessons that will help them on the field, help them off the field currently in their college, and help them throughout their entire lives and all their relationships they have. So that's the kind of the highlights for me this summer. Mm-hmm. The last one that I will say, not the last couple, one is I dropped my son off and we did the orientation and everything at Biola. He's playing there. Go Eagles. Awesome. So that's been a really cool journey with him. Some amazing, amazing things have happened to be able to get him there and to be able to help us to afford it financially. Some miracles happen there to be able to do that. And then my daughter's getting ready to go to Hawaii for a YWAM discipleship training school. And then she's going to go somewhere after that for 3 months, somewhere in the world. They place her somewhere. So a huge adventure for her coming up in the next few months. So I'm super proud of my kids and what they're doing. My younger one's starting high school and junior high. And so Beck and I are getting older. There's no question about that. I turned 48 over the summer. And I posted something the other day too. You may have seen it, where it says, you know, my body is 25 and my mind thinks my body's an idiot. Or I think my body's whatever. You know, you get the point.
Yeah, yeah.
But basically, I think I'm 25 still. And I am not. So anyway, so that's kind of what we had going on there. The other thing that you've neglected to mention, Paul, and it goes right into our summer series, is that your boy started playing American football this summer, too.
Oh, yeah.
And so, you know, and in honor of that, not really, but it goes, too. It's a good segue. You know, I love segues. We did our summer series on this, the Coaching Character Podcast, which really was all about American football. And we thought, you know, it's a good idea to get some, change it up a little bit, give us a break, like we said, so we could spend some time with our families doing these really cool things, but also just learn some really cool lessons from some people that are doing things in the world of American football. So I didn't even know that with your son, but it is a tribute to your son starting American football. Yeah. So
Well, technically, I've got two sons that have started American football.
Oh, okay.
I think one of the a post that I put on Instagram at one point, I actually referred to it as American football.
Yes.
Because that's, I didn't want to confuse anybody. And a friend of mine commented that they thought I was being like jabbing at it. And I'm like, no, I was actually just being clear that, you know, if I put football, a lot of people that I know will assume it's soccer. So I have to be, clear
that
it's American football. So I'm not jabbing at anyone.
Well, and I can tell you there have been jabs. The most comments, I think by far the most commented on, and on this note, folks, please comment, give us feedback on these episodes, give us, you know, feedback on who you want to see on this show. But the most commented show we've had is the one with Clyde Best, and I thought it was because it was really good interviews, right? Like I was very proud of those interviews. They were a good, you know, he's a good friend. He's part of our family. Amazing story, amazing lessons. But the comments are not that. The comments are not, oh, good job, great job, lad. You know, nothing like that. It's not soccer, it's football. It's football, you idiot. You know, stuff like that. That's basically why, you know, this is rubbish. I couldn't even listen to the whole, you know, you can guess what country it's coming from, but I couldn't even listen to the whole interview because you kept saying soccer, it's football, it's football. And, you know, and I get that. I get what they're saying. Okay. To a certain extent. And then I say, get over it.
Yeah,
we're in America. And if we say football, people are going to think we're talking about American football. And so, and by the way, soccer comes from a British term, association football. So it actually comes from that, the SOC. They made it into soccer. So some English men and women call it soccer as well, which is a little known fact. That being said, I understand global football, and we understand that. But you're right. If you say football and if I say football to certain people, they're going to be confused. So we don't want to do that. We want to keep it so we avoid confusion on this show, right? That's a big part of communication. Anyway, so, but yeah, I mean, two of the things we talked about in those episodes that Roz and I talked about were Remember the Titans and Rudy. And I know you got some thoughts about Remember the Titans and Rudy just because great, great sports movies that it doesn't get much better than that. So what are your thoughts on that? I just got to at least hear that from you.
Well, they're two of the best sports movies of all time. And what's funny is just in the conversation the last couple of weeks about what movies do we need to see, what's the newest movies, it came up in a group that Rudy came up again. I'm like, oh man, I haven't seen that in forever. That's such a good movie. I'd like to like sit down and watch that. We're talking about movies to watch with our kids. And those are some of the classic ones that we need to go back and watch, but just so much great content in there. And little known fact, our family has a connection to Rudy through some different things. I won't get into that, but that was much later that I found that out. But yeah, the movies are awesome. The life lessons in both of those movies are a lot of fun to watch through. So yeah, classics for sure. And probably two movies that I need to sit down with the boys and watch as well.
There's all kinds of other stuff we talked about on Coaching Character. If you didn't listen to those episodes because you thought, well, it's not Paul and Phil, so what's the point? You know, and I could get that because if Paul's not on it, I mean, what is the point? That's what I you know, say to people. But there's some really good nuggets in those episodes. There's some really good things talking about coaches, how you can incorporate character, how you can incorporate integrity, how you can incorporate really these leadership principles, life principles into your coaching. Practical tips, practical tools for that. You know, we didn't just do it this summer because we needed to fill it with something. We could have filled it with all kinds of stuff. We purposefully did this because these episodes were very good, and they wouldn't have been released otherwise. So I thought, what a great opportunity to be able to kind of give this a break and give you great content throughout the summer. So check that out. Go back and listen to those, you know, because we talked about things that we are all talking about. And to hear it from a different perspective, we talked about that on the show too, right? We had Corey Close, we had John Yeager, lacrosse coach. We had another football guy, and I'm blanking on his name right now, of course. We've had almost 100 episodes. This is episode 99. Isn't that crazy?
Wow, that is crazy.
Now, 10 of them are the coaching, actually 12, I think, are the coaching character. But it was Hoffman. I'm blanking on his first name. But Hoffman was the quarterback. He played over in Europe. So we've had some different sports, and we just thought, you know what? It's good for us to remember that cross-sport learning is huge. So the other cool thing about those episodes is my cousin, Chris Sarris, super proud of him. He's like my little brother, coaching these teams. One of the other things, I'd be curious to hear this from you, is we had a question that we asked most of these guests, which was, what was the team that you most enjoyed playing on in all your different years of playing football with them? And I'll say, you know, global football, soccer with you. Or it doesn't even have to be soccer. What was the team that was the team that you had the most fun playing on?
Well, that's a question. I don't know that I've actually thought about the team that was the most fun. Was it the team that went to nationals and had the most success? That was a lot of fun. Or was it the team that was, when I was younger, with all my buds, and we just really enjoyed being together every weekend, that was coached by my dad? You know, I think there's different things that I could think through being older now. If you asked me 20 years ago, I'd probably say it was a team that went to youth nationals and competed, you know, for that. But there's also a piece of me that loved my college team. So I think there's so many different lenses through which I could look through to pick my favorite team. But, you know, all of them are surrounded by what is the overall experience and the people that you're around, that community that you have around you as you're competing and striving for things. So that's one I'd have to really, have to plot that one on a piece of paper. I think the pros and cons to the different teams that I played on.
Folks, right there, that is a lesson in disc right there. Yeah. Paul is a C personality style. He's going to plot it on a piece of paper to see what the pros or cons are so he can answer that question. Fun is not necessarily the driver of a high C, which is an interesting question. As I was asking the question, I was laughing. I wanted to hear how you'd answer it. The interesting thing about these people, most of whom I know, most of whom are have that eye somewhere in them, but to a person, it was the most wins of their favorite team was one, and they had so much fun on those teams, and they learned life lessons on those teams. You know, going back to Phil DuBois, who was he played for the Washington Redskins back in the 70s, and he talked about the fact that when he was coaching a team, he just told them during the draft to say, "Hey, just give me the kids that no one else wants." You know, and he said he took that team, and they had a lot of fun together in that team, even though they didn't win games.
Yeah.
Because you can, you know, you're not focusing on just the winning. It's not as toxic when you're at that point, because people aren't freaking out if you didn't do everything just right and just perfect. You're able to learn those lessons more in that winning, right? You're either winning or learning, is a famous quote that's out there. So anyway, there's a lot of things like that were covered in those episodes. And that was always an interesting question that we asked, but most of them were like, we were 0-10, we were 0-8. An earlier episode that wasn't in the summer series was with Harrison Phillips, and he played for the Bills, now playing for the Vikings. I mean, he said the same thing. It was a team that was 0-8. And it's super interesting to hear that, because we do focus on all that. And yes, it is fun to win, and we love winning nationals and going to nationals. But I talked to my daughter about it. Her team went to nationals, and the team was toxic, and it wasn't super fun to play on the team. It was fun to win, but that's different, right? And so when you look back, as you said, and if I have never plotted it on a piece of paper, but if hypothetically I were to, you know, there are a lot of pros and cons, right? So anyway, so folks, go back, check that out. We're gonna keep this episode relatively short, so we're not gonna go back and do a full, you know, debrief on all those episodes, but I encourage you, go back, check them out, and, you know, if it's something that any one of them piques your interest, go back and listen to it. But Roz has a lot of wisdom to share. You know, I kind of spitballed some stuff throughout the summer, or throughout those episodes as well, and we wanted to share them with you. So, and we also want to share with you the content that we normally bring to you, and we love bringing to you, which is from people in the world of global football, known in the United States as soccer. Just for people out there who are going to get mad at me for saying soccer. Boy, one thing I also forgot, I'm wearing my Sac Republic shirt here, because
oh, yeah.
They didn't quite pull it out They lost last night in the U.S. Open Cup final, but super proud of my local boys here for making it all the way to only the third team in history from a lower division to make it to the U.S. Open Cup final. I thought it was a little, you know, kind of jacked up that they had to play in Orlando at Orlando Stadium for that game, but it is what it is, you know. But they... valiant effort, and took it I think 60 something minutes before Orlando scored, so it was a very, very great, you know, great run. Beat four MLS teams in the process, so that's another thing, you know. And I'm wearing my Manchester United hat because they're actually, you know, they're looking like a team again, so that's good.
Getting back to normal, I guess.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, I'm glad you said it. I'm glad you said it. So my kids have never known a team that was, you know, doing really, really well. They never known that dominant Manchester United. I don't think they're going to be dominant anytime soon, not with City around. But it'll come. It all goes in cycles, right? Yeah. But anyway, so we have this new episode coming our way. I mean, these new episodes, this new season, season 7. Yep. You know, great number 7. You know, what are you excited about this season?
Yeah, I mean, kind of like you said, I'm ready to get back to the, you know, the global football conversations, and got obviously, as always, some really amazing guests lined up, which always lead to just some amazing conversations. I'm excited to jump into a few of those interviews also. So you and I get to kind of tag team questions on our guests, which is a lot of fun, which is a little bit different. We've done a few through the past, but I think this season we're trying to be a little bit more intentional with both of us jumping on, which should be a lot of fun and has been, as we've done some already. But yeah, I'm looking forward to it, man. Just so much great content. I, you know, as I think we say every halftime and postseason show, I mean, I personally love it just because I learned so much from it. So selfishly, I just gained so much from these episodes. So to get kind of back into that again and navigating that, I'm excited, man. So I'm really excited about what's coming in season 7. It's crazy to think that, you know, we're going to be in the hundreds here pretty soon.
Yeah, episode 100. This is 99, like I said, one away from 100 episodes, which is crazy, you know, and that is a lot of content. And that it's a great thing to be at that number. And then the other side is, it's daunting for people coming in and being like, I haven't listened to all those, and I got to go back and listen all right now. No, you don't have to go back and listen to all of them. I encourage you to, at some point, be listening 2x speed if you need to. But there are just some really, really great people, great stuff. But just go and, you know, peruse through it. Check them out. See which ones you love. Listen to the 20 memorable moments episode that we did. It's actually at the top of the HowSoccerExplainsLeadership.com website. You can just go check out that episode and give you a little, you know, tidbits from those different episodes that we thought were worthy of that 20. And, you know, it's not just those 20. That was really hard to choose. I think we even had a bonus one, right? Boy, that's something that I look at and go, what are the things that we can bring to you this season? And so the first one that will come out of the shoot next week is with a good friend, Dan Williams. He's a guy that's he's got a daughter who's playing at your alma mater there, Paul. You know,
right.
So talking
go
about
hose.
Yeah,
blue hose.
The blue hose, which is a very interesting mascot, I'm not going to lie. And, you know, you have blue hose on your shirt, and it's just, what does that even mean? I don't know. I mean, maybe you can shed some light on what is the blue hose.
So it's basically, think of Braveheart.
Yes.
And when Scotsmen would go into battle, they would wear blue stockings.
Okay.
So originally they were the blue stockings.
Okay.
And then I don't know why we went with hose, but that's what it was. So yeah, it's an interesting, but think of Braveheart, you know, tough, fierce.
Yeah.
You won't get that. Yeah. You don't get that from blue hose, but think that.
Yeah.
I want you to think
so basically,
that.
Yeah. So does the mascot just wear pantyhose and run around? Like what's the.
Easy now. You know, it's a Christian college. They're wearing more than
pantyhose. That's why I'm wondering. That's why I'm wondering what's going on here.
Braveheart. You want to talk trash to Braveheart? You go ahead. I'm not messing with Braveheart.
I'm just saying. You know? I hear blue hose. I don't think Scottish battlefield. I'm not going to lie. That's not what comes to my mind. But, you know, that's good. I can see it. I see the blue paint. Mel Gibson on his face.
Think Mel Gibson in Braveheart, not
in
Mel Gibson
Braveheart.
In any other film.
Yeah, no other film. Well, nothing else. Mm-hmm. Lethal Weapon maybe, because he was pretty solid in the Lethal Weapon series.
Pretty solid.
But that's so interesting, the blue pantyhose. So
we had a T-shirt that said, "What the heck is a blue hose?" And it would have different pictures of like a blue garden hose, a garden hoe, socks. It'd have all kinds of, you know, So we make fun of ourselves with it as well. But
that's
don't,
good, as you should.
Don't mess with the blue hose. That's what I would say. So
yeah, I would not. I would not, obviously. Yeah. I mean, because you are just a very manly man that was produced out of Presbyterian College, and so I would never mess with that. Because if you are the you know kind of prototype Presbyterian College grad, then I definitely wouldn't mess. So, but Dan's daughter is now playing there, getting back to the point of what we were talking about. And he also is helping people just with leadership and training and at the younger ages and being able to help them in all areas, all aspects. He's done incredible different sports ministry around the world for decade, but he's able to share with us some stuff next week. We've got another guy, Jorge Vallejo, we're going to be interviewing. He was coach of the year. I forget the exact. He was coach of the year by some organization that I'm forgetting right now, but we're going to talk all about it when we interview him. But anybody who
listen
wins coach
in,
of the year with
listen
anything,
in and get that.
Yes. Anybody coach of the year on anything, he's got a lot of really cool stuff to share. He's also done some great work in Honduras and that Central America ministry connection with all the work time that I was able to be in Honduras. So I'll be able to talk about some of that stuff, different things we can learn from these guys about how they have used soccer and the lessons and their different work that they're doing locally, globally. You can hear all that. We're going to have some legends in coaching. Not going to name any names. Just going to leave it out there hanging. Legendary coaches that are going to be sharing stuff with us this season, getting some other people who are other coaches, other players, played at high levels, different areas. And so we have some people in mind. We have some people we've already set up. No doubt this season is going to bring some really, really cool stuff for you, as most of the seasons have. So I am getting excited to get back into it, like we said, and hopefully you are too. And so we're gonna wrap this up. Paul, do you have any last words for our people about season 7, about anything else that you just want to share, something that's just gonna blow their hose off right now?
No, I don't. And I just think that if you are joining in at the beginning of the 100s, don't be overwhelmed. Just jump in where you can. And, you know, I think you'll get a lot out of this. And I know that those that are used to listen to this that are regulars, I know they're probably excited as well and hopefully got a lot out of the summer from the series that you put together. And yeah, I mean, I just love to get feedback from folks and looking forward to hitting season 7 here, man.
Yeah, and that feedback is critical. We mentioned it at the beginning. I'm going to talk about it again because it's something that podcasting is an interesting trade. It's one that is usually very passive on the audience standpoint, but we want to change that. We want you guys to really be part of this conversation as guests. You know, if you're listening to this, I guarantee you have something to offer. So you might be a great guest for this. You might know people who would be great guests for this. And so we want you to be able to share with us those things, but also comments on it. Comment on any of the social media platforms that we're on. You can comment on the website. You can leave feedback and rate and review the show on Apple Podcasts so people can see that. And the most important thing, I think, is if this is helping you, I guarantee it will help other people in your circles. So share it with them. Just, you know, send them a text. Say, hey, I listened to this today. I think it's really interesting for you. I've sent out texts recently for people when they ask a question about something. I say, actually, you can go listen to this episode. You know, I've referred people to the Brad Miller episode when they're struggling with some mental health things and with some of the sports psychology side of things. Dan Abrams as well. We've referred people to Don Williams and the episode on recruiting multiple times. You know, and those are just a handful of different people. But it doesn't have to be, hey, I wouldn't necessarily say just go listen to this podcast, because people are, again, they look at it, they're overwhelmed. Especially now, the last 10 episodes have been things that aren't our normal programming. Right, so just pick an episode that you might be your episode. If you're not sure which one to listen to, somebody asks, "Hey, which one should I listen to and start with?" I just send them to that 20 memorable moments because it gives them a sampler platter, so to speak. So do that. You know, that's something that will help not only get this podcast out. We're never gonna. I mean, maybe we will if something weird happens, but I don't ever foresee us being this, you know, massive million downloads a month podcast. But we really want to have impact. That's our goal here, is to be able to impact lives, impact teams, impact clubs, impact programs to be able to help you in what you're doing and help other coaches and players to be able to flourish. You know, I've had coaches call me and say how it's helped them and impacted them and their teams. I've had players impact me. I've had parents call and say, you know what, I've listened to your episodes. I listen to every episode and it helps me understand my player better. And it helps me to be able to listen with my player, anywhere from 12 to 25, you know, different people who have had kids that they've shared it with their children to be able to help. So all of that, I think, could be ways you can use this and, you know, again, share it with others, because that's what they say, sharing is caring, right? So I think they say that in kindergarten, but it also applies here. You know, if you care about people and you think it will help them, then share this, share other podcasts too, not just this one. I know that I've shared all kinds of podcasts with people because I know that it's an easy way, rather than handing them a book with, you know, they probably won't read, give them an episode that's an hour, 45 minutes. And then, you know, they can listen to that and hopefully it will help them to be able to flourish in different ways. And so folks, with that, you know, I do hope that you are, you know, listening to these different episodes. I hope that you're engaging with them. I hope that you're talking with people about them. Hope that everything you're learning from these episodes, as we always say, every episode, I'm going to say this because I truly believe it. I hope that you're taking everything you're learning from these episodes and this podcast and these conversations, and you're using them to help you be a better coach, a better leader, a better parent, a better spouse, better in every relationship that you have. And that you're continually reminding yourself that soccer does explain life and leadership. Thanks a lot. Have a great week.